If you recognize this model car, it's because you probably know it as Doc and Marty McFly's time machine from Back to the Future. It also served as the inspiration for Alef's real-life flying car, a model of which is right behind me.
Alef Aeronautics is still in the early stages of developing a vehicle that it hopes can be driven on the roads and flown above them. To find out more, I caught up with co-founder and CEO, Jim Dukhovny.
Nice to meet
Thank you.
You
so much. We're here at Alef's warehouse in San Mateo, California. And what are we seeing today? Flying cars?
We're seeing flying cars.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
You guys are more ambitious than most eVTOLs out there. You have to create a car and basically an aircraft. Why bite off so much?
Even though it's a similar technology, eVTOL are pretty much electric helicopters. Yeah. We're trying to build a car which can vertically take off and fly efficiently.
Did you expect this to take so long?
When we first met in a coffee shop in Palo Alto, I drew something on a napkin and I asked, how long is it gonna take to build this one, big one, and everything in 2015? They said half a year.
Half a year turned into 8 years.
We're still building.
But you actually have a target date. You want to get at least one of these on the road slash air in 2025.
We plan to. If everything goes right, if we have enough funds, if the legislation does not get worse, we're okay with today's legislation, we plan to start production of the first one by the end of 2025.
But getting there won't be easy. Unlike its eVTOL competitors, Alef will need to get approval from two regulators, the Federal Aviation Administration and the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
In the long term, we do want to make a full certification. If you look at this as an aircraft, all the propellers and everything which makes it fly are internal. Nothing is exposed. This is a major thing. It's only one or two person vehicle, which is again advantage during the certification. It's lightweight, it's very safe. So if you compare that to any traditional aircraft which flying today, this is way safer. So in the long term, we also have an easier way of certification because we thought about all of this before we started building everything.
Alongside certification, of course, Alef needs funding. So far, its most notable backer is venture capitalist Tim Draper, who was an early investor in both Tesla and SpaceX. And perhaps most notoriously, Theranos.
Tell me about how you started to raise money for this. It was a cold email, right?
Yes.
Who was that to and what did you write?
So I thought about the biggest name in the world, which I knew, which was Tim Draper.
How long from that cold email till he wrote you a check? How long did that take?
Surprisingly enough, that was almost a year. Tim wanted to make sure that not only it makes sense business-wise, he wanted to make sure it made sense engineering-wise too.
A lot of folks out there seem to think that Tesla, SpaceX, both of them, are an investor in Alef.
We have no affiliation with SpaceX. I never saw Elon, only on TV.
So we have just a firm no from you. No SpaceX, no Tesla investment.
No affiliation whatsoever.
As well as seed money, Alef is also taking pre-orders. For a $150 deposit, customers can get on a list to purchase its Model A when it becomes commercially available. That deposit, by the way, is fully refundable.
So revenue will be starting once we start delivering, right? We have already 3,000 and the number keeps growing. Right.
Of pre-orders.
Of pre-orders, correct.
Let's talk about the price tag.
Sure.
$300,000 when it comes out.
Yeah.
Not a lot of people can afford that.
I cannot afford it. Pretty much you can afford it. So the price tag came from cost, what it takes us to make one today. We make it pretty much here, handmade, a lot of man hours and so on.
So how does Alef's car actually work? Well, I tried asking a couple of times, but didn't really get a clear answer. Oleg Petrov is Alef's director of R&D.
So Oleg, this is the Model A. So from far away, it looks like a car, but then when you come up close, it's actually nothing inside of it, but the blades and the air has to go all the way through, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So explain how that works.
Because we had to do that, right? Because it's a vertical takeoff.
Yes.
And here where that area matters, that's what creates thrust and it lifts it up. in the area. And we are very efficient because they are very hollow. We are very efficient in that and very lightweight. We have to do it. And also when it flies, it goes this side looking forward.
This side looks forward, so it moves, you were telling me.
Air goes through.
So I can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4 blades here, and then there's 4 more in the back,
Same on the back, yeah.
And does 8. It all have to balance?
Yes, there's going to be a lot of more mechanics here. It's not just the motors and propellers, like a little special mechanism. We have a lot of like surfaces. It's much more complicated than it may look like.
I still wouldn't say I fully understand how the technology actually works, but perhaps that's still proprietary information at this stage. All I know is that we did not get to see the vehicle actually in the air or driving on a road.
So there you have it, guys. This was Alef's facility that is creating the flying car that we have really imagined for decades. We'll see, they still have a long road to go in terms of approval, in terms of funding, in terms of getting that price down. But what we saw today was at least a glimpse of the future.